Good morning, students. Now let us discuss another question. A cylinder with a movable piston contains 3 moles of hydrogen at standard temperature and pressure. The walls of the cylinder are made of a heat insulator and the piston is insulated by having a pile of sand on it. By what factor does the pressure of the gas increase? The gas is compressed to half of its original volume. So you can observe this question. The walls of the cylinder are made of heat insulator, and also this entire system is separated from the surroundings by a pile of sand on it. That means the system is considered as an isolated system. It is entirely isolated from this surrounding. So this process we can say that the adiabatic process only. So in this case, the equation EV ratio gamma is considered as a constant. So when you consider this equation EV ratio gamma is considered as a constant. When the process is adiabatic process, so we have to consider this equation EV ratio gamma is considered as a constant. That means we can write this equation as P1 ratio gamma is equal to P2 ratio gamma. So here we have to find what is the, you can observe that by what factor does the pressure of the gas increases. So we have to calculate P2 by P2, the ratio only we have to calculate. So for that we can take this as a V1 raised to gamma divided by V2 raised to gamma is equal to P2 divided by P1. So this way we can rearrange in our equation. So P2 divided by V1 is equal to, you can see that V1 divided by V2 raised to gamma. Now we can rearrange this equation, you can see that V2 divided by V1 is equal to, you can see that in this case V2 is equal to half of its original volume. That means V1 divided by V1 by 2 raised to gamma. Yeah, so the gamma value is also given. Gamma value is given as 1.2. That means our equation becomes P2 divided by V1 is equal to, you can cancel this, ultimately 2 raised to 1.4 is 1. So this is the, we can calculate this ratio. That means P2 by V1 is considered as 2 raised to 1.4 is coming as, you can observe that. So this value is coming as 2.64. So 2.64. So this is the way we can calculate this ratio.